Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Epic Flight Academy in beautiful New Smyrna Beach, Florida. This is Epic's instrument rating course, and I'm your host, Mike Thompson. Remember, to be successful in this course, there are three keys. Number one, you should be enrolled in Epic's online course and reading and studying the materials in that course. And number two, boy, are we glad you're here watching these videos. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And these videos are designed to parallel that content. Now, along the way, should you have any questions, key number three is, of course, as always, review all of this content with your flight instructor. So let's get started. We are wrapping up holding and holds. To wrap this up, we want to talk about airway holds and maintaining the hold. So airway holds means that we're holding on a fix associated with a published airway. Now, this is actually a very common ATC instruction. And if you take a look at the excerpt from our online course, I'm going to give you an example of what an ATC instruction might sound like. They might say, hold southwest of the skipped intersection on Victor 160, expect further clearance at 1830 Zulu. So what am I going to do? What would this hold look like? Well, take a look. We see the blue Mesa VOR, that's HBU, Hotel Bravo Uniform, and going out to the northeast, you see Victor 160. And on that Victor airway, we find the skipped intersection. That is S-K-I-P-T. Now, they want us to hold southwest of that intersection on the Victor airway. Notice they did not tell us to turn left, so that hold would look like this. You see, we've drawn it in for you in red. So if I'm holding southwest of the skipped intersection on Victor 160, my inbound course would be northeast to skipped with right turns. So I'd be inbound on 050 and outbound on 230. Now, I'm sure you've already gone over this as a private pilot, and I'm sure you're reviewing it with your instrument instructor. The Victor airway numbering is not the radial. So you see that Victor 160 is not radial 160. It's actually radial 050. So what if the instruction said, hold northeast of skipped on Victor 160. Expect further clearance at 1830. Well, you would be right on the Victor airway, and you're going to hold to the northeast of it on Victor 160. And once again, we have drawn in the hold for you here in red. What if you were approaching the Blue Mesa VOR DME? And take a look again at our graphic. Notice the six-sided box with the square around it. That tells me what? That it's a VOR with a DME. Exactly. And we are approaching from the southwest, and we are inbound to the Blue Mesa VOR DME, and I have these instructions to hold northeast of skipped. Notice I'm going to fly directly to the VOR DME, and then the green dotted line here shows me flying outbound on Victor 160 to skipped. And referring back to a previous video, you should be able to do this in your head now. What type of an entry will we make? We are going exactly opposite of our inbound course. And if you said either teardrop or parallel, you are correct. Now, another common ATC instruction might be to hold as published. Well, what do they mean by that? Well, take a look back at our example. We're back at the Blue Mesa, VORDME, and our big blue line here is depicting a published hold. Do you see the light gray line there? Now remember, the inbound leg of a holding pattern is always to the fix. So you can see we are on radial 211 holding southwest of Blue Mesa. And do you see anything slightly out of the ordinary about this published hold? I do. And it is the fact that it shows left-hand turns. Well, not a problem. Let's imagine that we're in our aircraft here at the bottom of the screen, and our inbound course, once again, is this green dashed line directly to the fix. How will I enter the published hold? And if you said a direct entry over Blue Mesa, you nailed it. So please review all of these with your flight instructor. Now, once we are in the hold, the second part of today's lesson is talking about maintaining that hold. So here in our diagram, we are showing the inbound leg to the station. We're flying to the west, so we're holding on the east side. We're holding east of this holding fix. We are making right-hand turns, and these legs are either 1 minute, if I am below 14,000 feet, and or a DME distance, right? So have a look. I have a perfectly shaped racetrack, and all of you are going to be such precise instrument pilots. That's exactly what your holding pattern is going to look like, right? Probably not. Why not? Not because you're not a skillful pilot, but because this is depicted in perfect conditions with zero wind. Well, as you start to fly and gain experience, you realize, zero wind conditions are actually very rare. And if you find a zero wind condition at, say, 6 a.m. in the morning at your local airport, you know it's not going to be zero wind for long. And at altitude, of course, there is always wind. So that holding pattern might look a lot more like this. Now, here we are again. We're holding to the east, inbound leg is to the west, and we're flying to that red holding fix. Notice our large blue arrow here is winds out of the south. So, my aircraft on its inbound leg, do you see the wind correction angle here? Or we sometimes call it a crab angle. Yeah, to hold that inbound course, I've got my crab angle. Now, I'm going to start my right-hand turn as I cross the fix. And here's where it gets interesting. When we are flying instruments, and your instructor, I'm sure, has taught you this, or you're working on it right now, all turns are to be made at what? Standard rate. That's exactly correct. So we can't say things like turn at a 10 degree bank angle or a 15 or 20 degree bank angle. No, we say all turns are made at a standard rate of 3 degrees per second, unless I'm in a high speed aircraft and I'm using half standard rate. But say we're in a 172S, we're turning at 3 degrees per second. The actual bank angle will vary according to airspeed. Well, actually ground speed, but yeah, that's exactly correct. So remember, as a private pilot, if I wanted to hold a constant radius from this red dot right here, With that southerly wind, I would just vary my bank angle and hold a constant radius. Now, on instruments, we are not doing that. We are flying at a standard rate turn. So, notice how that southerly wind makes this first right turn have a large radius. Well, if I just were to fly straight east, I'm slowly going to start drifting north, and it's going to be very difficult to recover that inbound leg to the fix. So, here is the solution. Whatever this wind correction angle was on the inbound leg, do you see my little crab angle here? Let's say that was 10. On the outbound leg, triple it. Mike, do you mean on the outbound leg, my wind correction angle or my crab angle should be 30 degrees? That sounds like a lot. Yes. Whatever it was on the inbound leg, triple it. So now you see my aircraft with the crab angle on the outbound leg is with a much, much larger crab angle. And that makes this odd-shaped holding pattern. And when I get to the outbound end of this holding pattern, notice as the aircraft makes that right-hand turn, it rolls right in on the inbound leg. Well, is that because it turned at a steeper bank angle and made a smaller radius? No. Remember, all turns are made at standard rate. The larger wind correction on the outbound leg moved me closer to the inbound leg, and that's what compensates for the wind. When I roll out on the outbound end, I should roll out very close to my inbound course. So, folks, that is the topic for today. Airway holds and maintaining those holds with wind. Please be sure to go through all of that with your flight instructor and join us next time.